You're having a baby! Congratulations! You are ready to bring your newborn home, and you're looking for the essential newborn items for your baby months 1 through 3.
And we've got the list for you.
Whether you're a first-time mom, a 10th-time mom, a COVID-19 mom, we have the list for everyone who's having a baby.
We wrote down all the items and links to the items in the description below.
Yeah, so sit back, relax, take a breather as we go through the baby newborn essential items for months 1 through 3 with you. I'm Liana.
And I'm Erin.
And we're a mom's best friend. The YouTube channel to help make your mom life
a little bit easier. If you like what you see today, make sure to subscribe, like, and hit the notifications bell.
And comment below if you have any additional newborn items that we didn't mention. And be sure to share this channel with a new mom that you know.
If you haven't already, make sure you create a baby registry.
Yeah, and the one that we recommend is Amazon. There's so many benefits for why Amazon Baby Registry, in my opinion, is the best one. For starters, they send you an absolutely free welcome baby kit, which is so cute. It includes a swaddle and a few other things that is just like a little present to you as a pregnant mom.
You can also get discounts on diapers.
Yeah, for the entire first year of having a baby, Amazon will give you a huge discount on diapers, and they show up right at your house.
You can also add items from other sites onto your Amazon list.
Yes, and this is such a great way to share with your family, friends, coworkers, and network what it is that you and your family need for your newborn.
We added a link in the description below that'll take you right to Amazon's baby registry page.
Also, I recommend you sign up for Amazon Prime.
It's just honestly a click away. Like if you need diapers, you click it, and then within the next business day or 2 business days, it'll be right at your front door.
Yeah, I have bought so many items off Amazon Prime. It really saves you and your family a trip to the store, and you're gonna need that time at home, not driving to the store. So I really recommend signing up for a delivery service like Amazon Prime.
The first item we recommend, especially if you're nursing, is my Breast Friend pillow.
This pillow is awesome for a newborn because it clicks on around your waist and the baby can rest right there. It saves your arms so that you don't have to be holding your baby so much. I really recommend it. The next item is a bassinet. We loved having our bassinet right next to our bed. We could move it from mom's side to dad's side, or we could move it to other rooms if we needed to. It's perfect for a newborn and it works for the first 3 months. Ours had a cover to zip up in case you have pets or anything that you don't want to get into the bassinet.
Another item is the glider rocker. It's a rocking chair that has a little footstool that rocks with you. It's very comfortable. You're going to be using this item a lot. Anytime you feed your baby, if you just want to rock your baby, hold your baby, if family members come over to hold your baby, then they can rock with them as well.
Yeah, and we ended up buying 3 glider rockers. So we could have one in our bedroom, one in the nursery, and one downstairs in the living room. This is what worked best for us so that we had the option to rock the baby wherever we were in the house. The next item on the list is the Boppy Lounger pillow. This is so convenient for a newborn because if you need to put them down for a minute to wash your hands, or just somewhere to place them while you're hanging out with your baby. It's a snug pillow and it's just so convenient. I highly recommend it. We used it a lot. Next item on the list are swaddles. Here is a swaddle that we recommend. And the bigger the better. These lightweight muslin swaddles are really awesome. And we're probably going to make a how to swaddle your baby video. So be sure to check that out on our YouTube channel. They also come in Velcro. And the Velcro ones are really convenient and super easy in the middle of the night just to Velcro them together. So I do recommend those as well.
So you're going to also want a changing pad. This one is really nice because it has contoured edges, so if your baby does end up rolling a little bit, they're not going to go right off the side because this will help keep them centered.
One thing that goes with your changing pad is a liner, and you'll want a bunch of these. Maybe we had about 20, we kept ordering more, but you'll want probably at least 5 to start out, because if it gets like poop or anything on there or spit up, you can just put it in the wash. And you'll want a cover to go with your changing pad.
So you're going to be feeding your baby a lot, and after each feeding, you're supposed to burp your baby. So you're probably going to get a little bit of spit up, maybe a lot of spit up, it depends. So you don't want to get it all over your clothes or all over your furniture or all over your family members. So burp cloths are a must.
One item that I didn't know if I would need or not, but I ended up being very grateful that I had them, is pacifiers. Our baby loves to suck on things 24/7, so having a pacifier for our baby to suck on was so convenient. Babies love to suck on things, and this is a personal decision whether or not you want to do pacifiers, but for me, it was really convenient. I will link down below the pacifier that my baby loved the most, and the reasons why is because it fit his tiny little mouth. There are different pacifiers to fit different ages. So if one pacifier doesn't work for your baby, try a different size and a different brand. I think we tried probably 5 brands to find the one that our baby loved the most. So Erin and I both use the same video monitor, and we really recommend this one for a few reasons. One reason is because some baby monitors use Wi-Fi, but this baby monitor is a close proximity frequency, and it's less likely to get hacked by people over Wi-Fi. This monitor came up as the most safe, less likely hackable camera, and my husband did a lot of research on it, and I did as well. So this is why we highly recommend this baby monitor. However, it does not connect to your phone, so if you want to see your baby from your phone, maybe if you're not even home, if you work full time and you want to see the babysitter, this monitor is not going to work that way.
If you are looking for a Wi-Fi baby monitor that connects straight to your phone and digital devices, we have one listed below. Bottles? How many baby bottles do you need?
That is such a good question. So yes, we recommend somewhere between 3 to 5 bottles to start out. The most popular bottle is the Dr. Brown's bottle. Me and my husband tried probably 5 different companies, and Dr. Brown's and Even Flow, which is 2 separate companies, were the best for our baby. No matter what bottle company you choose, you're going to want the size preemie nipple because it has a slow flow. One thing I didn't know before having a baby is that the baby bottle nipples have different flows, and it does affect how the baby drinks the milk.
So whenever you store your milk, if you have pump and you have storage for it, it's going to be cold because it's in the fridge or freezer. So another item you would want to have is a bottle warmer. So you put the milk in the bottle and then you put the bottle in the warmer, and after a few minutes, it warms up just the perfect temperature for your little one.
And another benefit for using bottles is to allow your partner or your friends or family to feed and bond with the baby. This was really convenient for me because I could pump milk and allow my husband to bottle feed the baby some of the time to help me get more sleep. I do recommend having a few bottles on hand to get started.
So to clean your bottles, you'll want a bottle brush cleaner, and that'll get within the bottle and within the nipple.
The baby bouncer was so convenient for us to use because when the baby wanted to fall asleep for a quick nap, a cat nap in the living room, we could put the baby in the baby bouncer and it vibrates and you can rock it with your foot. And they love looking up at the little toys that are hanging above them between the boppy and the baby bouncer chair. It gave us another place to put the baby during the day.
A good idea is getting blackout curtains for your baby because they're going to be sleeping all throughout the day and all throughout the night at different times. And so depending on the time, you might want to have some darkness for your baby so that they can get a restful and peaceful sleep.
One item that you will want to consider getting is a dim nightlight that is bright enough for you to see what you're doing, but dim enough that the baby still knows that it's nighttime. you're going to want your newborn to learn the difference between nighttime and daytime. So in the middle of the night, when you're feeding and changing the diapers, you're not going to want bright fluorescent lights in your room. One nightlight that we absolutely love, we still use it to this day, is the Moon nightlight. There's a lifetime warranty and they will replace it if it ever stops working. It's 3D printed to be an exact replica of the moon, but obviously a lot smaller. It comes in two different sizes and has, I think, around 10 different color options. And it's so beautiful. Our baby is always amazed by it, and I cannot recommend it enough. We're linking it down below.
Another item that is good to use to get your hands free but still have control of the baby is a baby wrap sling or carrier. This will allow you to wrap the baby right here so you have the baby, but then your arms are free. So you can either eat, you can do chores, you can do whatever you want, you can walk around. This is a very convenient way to carry your baby and also to multitask.
We love the baby wrap carrier because my husband could also wear it. He could put the baby on him, wrap it around, and it was great if we didn't want to bring the stroller for going for walks.
Extras!
This category are items that are not necessarily essential, but items that we use and we love, and they will make your first few months a lot easier.
Another item is a baby onboard car sticker or a magnet.
It's a good way to give other drivers a heads up that there's a precious new baby in your car. It also helps you to feel safer as a mom or dad, knowing that you have a warning on the car.
So another thing to think about is a nursing cover. If you want that privacy for yourself or for your child, that's something that you can consider getting.
One item that is not necessary but you will really cherish is a memory book. I love the memory book that I chose because I wanted something that had a lot of illustrations and not a lot of required writing. I did not want another project on my lap. So this one is super easy to just fill out the information, and it's a great way to track my baby's milestones.
So where are you going to put all your baby's dirty diapers? A good solution is the Diaper Genie. It's very easy to use, and you just put all the diapers in there. It closes really nice so that no stink gets out of it.
One item that you might want to get is a baby swing. We found it really convenient to put our baby in the baby swing if we needed to make dinner or take a quick shower, and it really is a good spot for them to take a cat nap.
So if you have any questions about your baby and want quick responses, we recommend this Baby 411 book. It's very well organized, it has tabs, it has a table of contents, and it's a quick go-to if you're looking for answers from your baby.
The Baby 411 book is recommended by my pediatrician and that pediatrician's entire office network.
It is important that it's doctor recommended because you can get all sorts of different conflicting answers online. So it's good to know that your pediatrician is backing these answers that you're getting in this book.
This is our Moses basket! One item that I recommend is a Moses basket. It's not essential, but if you want something that you can put the baby sleeping in and carry the baby with you around the house, it's really convenient. We put the Moses basket on the floor when we're eating dinner, and our baby is in a safe area to sleep or play, and we can keep an eye on him. We can also use it to carry from room to room or from upstairs to downstairs.
Do you need a crib starting out?
That's a really great question, and it's something that is a personal decision. However, in the first 1 to 3 months, your baby is most likely going to be sleeping in your room with you. So a bassinet is truly the way to go in the first 3 months. A crib is something you are going to need to get once the baby can roll over around months 3 to 4. So you will eventually need a crib, but in the first 1 to 3 months, a bassinet is probably what you're going to use. Do I need toys for my newborn?
Not very much, because whenever they're a newborn, they're just kind of starting working on like focusing their eyes. They can't even hold their heads up yet. So for the first couple of months, they're not going to be able to hold or interact with any toys.
Yeah, so around the end of 2 months, your baby's going to start exploring more and opening their eyes more, being awake more. And the first toy that we recommend is a baby play gym. And this is the type of thing where when your baby's laying down for tummy time or just laying on their back, they can look up and see things hanging down safely that they can reach and grab at. And we linked the one down below that my baby loves. It has a piano where he can kick his legs and reach up and play with the toys. And I really, really love that one.
So how many outfits do you need for your newborn?
That is such a good question and something that I really pondered before giving birth. So they're going to be swaddled most of the time. However, if you want a few baby outfits for the first month, feel free to buy it. But another thing to keep in mind is that your friends and family and coworkers and network love to buy baby clothes. So I would not buy hardly any baby clothes until after the baby is born, because you're probably going to end up with way more clothes than you actually need.
Some items that we mentioned in our last video, hospital bag must-haves,
that also apply to having a newborn baby, include a car seat, a car mirror,
a robe, and a breast pump.
And you'll also want some kind of camera to take pictures of your baby, whether it's from your phone or a DSLR camera, a point and shoot camera, an iPad, a tablet, whatever. You're gonna want pictures of your baby.
Congratulations! You have made it through our video of essential baby items for months 1 through 3.
If you like what you watched today, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe, share with a mom that you know, and comment below if you have any additional items, tips, tricks that will help new moms in our community.